Hello children, nice to see you again. After a long walk, I reached here. Yes, I am here in the middle of this field. Hey, listen, that's a familiar song.
Thithai thai 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 tharo, thagathai thai 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 tharo. Thithai thai 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 tharo, thagathai thai 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 tharo. Thithai thai 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 tharo. നേരം വെളുത്തില്ല പെണ്ണെ, നേരോടടുത്തില്ല പെണ്ണെ, ഒരു നൂല് തുണ്ടം കോരി വച്ചില്ല പെണ്ണെ.
Dear children, have you ever thought about the great responsibility of farmers? Yes, a farmer shoulders the responsibility of feeding the nation. His hard work keeps us away from starvation. Karshakar, avarude kashtapadana nammude annam. Don't you remember the poem Sower by Victor Hugo? The old sower in the poem is sincere, dedicated and hardworking. The poet conveys the greatness of the sower through the line, "His height seems to touch the starry skies." ആത്മാഭിമാനമുള്ള, ആത്മാർത്ഥതയുള്ള ഒരു കർഷകനെ നാം ആ പാഠഭാഗത്ത് പരിചയപ്പെട്ടു. വി കനോട്ട് അണ്ടർസ്റ്റിമേറ്റ് ദ ലൈഫ് ആൻഡ് സ്ട്രഗിൾ ഓഫ് എ ഹാർഡ് വർക്കിംഗ് മാൻ. ജസ്റ്റ് തിങ്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ വില്ലേജ് ബ്ലാക്ക് സ്മിത്ത് ബൈ ഹെൻറി ലോങ് ഫെലോ. ബിഫോർ മൂവിംഗ് ടു ദ സ്മിതി ഓഫ് ദ വില്ലേജ് ബ്ലാക്ക് സ്മിത്ത്, ലെറ്റ്സ് ചെക്ക് ദ അസൈൻമെൻറ്റ്.
Till saluted the Archduke. Velasco splashed water on his head. The boy spoke to his mother. The black passengers boycotted the buses. Portia saved the life of Antonio.
Good work, dear children. Go through other lessons and continue the same activity. ഞാനിപ്പൊ എവിടെ നിൽക്കുന്നു എന്ന് നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാമോ? Look here, we are standing in front of the smithy of the village blacksmith. Can you hear the blowing sound of his bellows? The village blacksmith is busy in smithy except on Sundays. Is he a hardworking man? Yes. The poet uses the expression, "His face is like the tan," to show the hard-working nature of the village blacksmith. In his smithy, you can see the burning sparks that fly like shafts. Don't you feel respect towards the village blacksmith for his dedication and toiling? ശരിക്കും ആ വ്യക്തിയോട് നമുക്ക് ബഹുമാനം തോന്നില്ലേ? Dear children, he is a person who balances his work life and personal life. It is true that our hard work, dedication, honesty and sincerity shape our life and future. വ്യക്തിജീവിതവും തൻ്റെ തൊഴിലും ഒന്നിച്ചു കൊണ്ടുപോയി സത്യസന്ധമായ ജീവിതം നയിക്കുന്ന ഒരു വ്യക്തിയായിരുന്നില്ലേ അദ്ദേഹം? Now, I will take you to an art gallery.
Dear children, do you know this painting? It is The Last Supper. Whose painting is this? It is painted by the world famous artist Leonardo da Vinci. Do you know the artist who painted Potato Eaters? It is Vincent van Gogh. Do you know this painting? It is Guernica. It is painted by Pablo Picasso. The world-famous painting Hamsam and Damayanti is portrayed by a famous Indian artist. Can you guess his name? He is Raja Ravi Verma. This painting is famous for its mysterious smile. Which is this painting? Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci. Do you know this painting? It is Light on the Hills. Let us meet the artist.
Dear children, can you tell me who drew this picture? Yes, he is the boy in the lesson, The Light on the Hills. The boy in the story, The Light on the Hills, realized the truth that our hard work, dedication, honesty, and sincerity shape our life and future. Now, he is a great painter. Let's see him. He is writing his diary after the exhibition.
It was a memories that gave me power to draw. Oh, my dear little sister, you are the one who I love the most in this world.
Do your work with dedication, then people will accept you.
How could I forget that beautiful day? You said the wisest things to me.
It's a beautiful world. It's a great honor to make things for it.
It is a sin to represent the world imperfectly.
You always do things better. You can do it. Do things for people who you love the most.
I must paint that picture. I promise my sister. I will draw that for her.
Now, children, let's see another diary entry. Dear children, did you read the diary entry? Whose diary entry is this? Yes, it's the diary entry of the artist in the story, The Light on the Hills. He has poured down his feelings and thoughts very well in the diary entry. We feel his pain as we read his words, don't we? Yes. That's how a diary entry is. It's a record of one's thoughts and feelings. The diary entry is written in the first person singular, which is proper. He has written a striking opening for the entry. Oh, I miss you so much, my little sister. How about the ending? The ending too is proper, as he wishes her soul rest in peace. But there is something missing in the diary entry. What is that? You said it right. The date and day of the entry is missing. So, my dear children, that was the diary entry of the artist on the day he had an exhibition of his paintings. He has expressed his thoughts and feelings in appropriate language. The first-person narrative has been used. He has given a striking opening and a proper ending. The only thing missing is the date and day. So let's add that for him and make his diary entry a proper model.
Dear children, practice diary writing in your life also. His sister's suggestions were an eye-opener to him, and he finally came up with a beautiful painting. നമ്മൾ ആത്മാർത്ഥമായി ഒരു പ്രവൃത്തി ചെയ്താൽ മറ്റുള്ളവർ നമ്മളെ അംഗീകരിക്കും. The boy was trying to make others happy through his art. മറ്റുള്ളവരെ സന്തോഷിപ്പിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടായിരുന്നു അദ്ദേഹം പടം വരച്ചത്. You know, hatred, greed and rivalry will turn our life miserable. That's what we saw in the life of Shylock in The Merchant of Venice by William Shakespeare. Do you remember the other characters? Very good. Antonio, Bassanio and Portia. Shakespeare, the master craftsman, here establishes that love and friendship can overpower the crookedness of Shylock. Can you say, where am I now? At the entrance of a school. At the entrance of Miss Beam's school. Do you miss your school? എന്തൊരു ചോദ്യമാണിത്. കൂട്ടുകാരെ കാണാൻ പറ്റിയിട്ടില്ല, കളിക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ല, ആഹാരം പങ്കിട്ട് കഴിക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ല. സ്കൂൾ നമുക്ക് പഠിക്കാൻ മാത്രമുള്ളതല്ലോ. The virus snatched away your sweet school days. I know, the loss is irreparable. But don't worry. Think about the good old days. The lively classrooms, teachers, chattering with your friends, their considerate and compassionate behavior. That's how a good school should be. Miss Beam's school was a school for sympathy in true sense. Why can't we write a letter to Miss Beam, congratulating her for running such a school?
Dear children, this is a letter written by a well-wisher congratulating Miss Beam for running a unique school. The language of the letter shows that the sender has written a personal, or rather, friendly letter to Miss Beam. If so, what should be the format of the letter? Yes, the letter should be an informal one. But here, the sender seems a bit confused about the format. She has mixed certain elements of a formal letter as she wrote the letter. Let's discuss on that. The letter begins with the sender's address. Then comes the date. The next is the receiver's address. But do we write the receiver's address in an informal letter? No, we don't do that. So that's an error. She has then written the subject line. But subject line is not a part of informal letter. We write subject line only for a formal letter. Then comes the salutation, which is written in an informal way. Dear Miss B. She begins the letter in an informal way with the sentence, "Hope you are doing well," which is apt. The language of the letter is informal and the content is apt. She congratulates Miss Beam and wishes her good luck as she closes the letter. The farewell phrase, "Yours lovingly," is proper. So children, now I guess you have got an idea on how to write an informal letter. Let me show you a model.
Dear children, don't you like the children in Miss Beam's school? Yes, they are an asset to our country. So caring and considerate. Sneham, Karuna, Sahanubhuti, ivayokke ayirunnille aa school pakarnu nalgiyathu. Mother Nature also cares about our well-being. Nature helps us whenever we are in trouble. Have you ever felt that? When the student in the story, the nightingale and the rose, was desperate, it was the nightingale and the rose who extended their support to him. But the ungrateful and materialistic world of mankind is indifferent and unmindful to the sacrifice of the nightingale. Dear children, we made a quick glance at the lessons of Standard 8 English test book. Now, I will take you to a game zone. I have some answers with me. You have to find add questions to make Simbu happy. നിങ്ങൾ ആ ഉത്തരം കിട്ടുന്ന ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ കണ്ടെത്തണം. എൻ്റെ കയ്യിൽ കുറച്ച് ഉത്തരങ്ങളുണ്ട്. This is a jungle. What question word can you use to get jungle as the answer? Which, when, where, what? Yes, what? So how will be that question? Yes. What is this? This is a jungle. Now the next answer. The lion is the king. What question word can you use to get the lion as the answer? Who, when, where, or what? Yes, who. So the question will be, who is the king? So the lion is the king. So the question, who is the king? The river is nearby. സ്ഥലമാണ് അല്ലേ. സ്ഥലമാകുമ്പോൾ ഏത് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ കൂടെ ഉപയോഗിക്കും? യെസ്. ഹു, വെൻ, വെയർ, ഓർ വാട്ട്? യെസ്, ഇറ്റ്സ് വെയർ. വെയർ ഈസ് ദ റിവർ? ഓക്കെ, മൈ നെക്സ്റ്റ് ആൻസർ ഈസ് യെസ്, ദ മങ്കി ഈസ് ഓൺ ദ ട്രീ. വാട്ട് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഈസ് ദിസ്? Yes, yes, yes or no question. So how can we start this question? We have to start with an auxiliary verb. So the helping verb or auxiliary verb is the monkey on the tree? Very good children, now our Chimbu is happy. Before wrapping up, let me give you the assignment for the day. Dear children, we are nearing towards the end of our journey. Together, we try to cross our difficult times. We always hold on the hope that there is going to be a better tomorrow. That's our dream. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. But dear children, our dreams come true through hard work and dedication. Ile sapnam kandukondirnal mathram adiyo. We should have a mind to attain that. Namak ad attain cheyanulla aspiration undavum. It is our aspiration to win that keep us moving ahead. I wish you good health, good luck for your new academic year. Thank you.